akong time dito rami sa sud sa among balay. Wala gyud minanggawas kay nang lupad namang sin. Unya nangabuak na ang mga kuan, mga jealousy. Ang among gibuhat ato ang higdaan na namo among giali namo sa among pamilya kay aron ma depensa lang nga dili mi maigo.
Pagkatapos ng bagyo, pumunta ako sa aming bahay. Pagkatapos ng pagkawa ng pagtanaw sa akong balay, haligi naman ako nakitaan. So, nagahilak ako ato.
Naghimo ko og gamay nga payag para sa kapuy-an sa akong pamilya. Nga, gamay lang nga, mga guba nga mga plywood.
May mga taong dumating doon sa amin. Tapos sinabihan kami na pag mayroon mga bahay na ano, pang ano sa amin.
Nung nakaibaw may ato na kuan, nanay ipatrabaho sa taga France, nagpasalamat ng dako.
Malipay yun kay ko nga, nakadawat ko, na-appeal ko sa usang beneficiaryo na aning babae.
Tinulungan kami, binigyan kami ng libreng bahay. Ang iyong pang, para pangbili namin ng pangayos ng bahay namin sa nagiba ng Yolanda, aming pinupundar para sa puhunan, additional namin para sa kapital sa pamimili ng isda.
Nung natanggap namin itong bahay at lupa, na-realize ko siguro blessing. Tapos nang natanggap namin itong bahay, nakapagtrabaho din ako.
Welcome back to Global Village. I'm Buddy Kunana. Tonight's topic is France-Philippines friendship, and specifically the wonderful projects that the Chamber, the French Chamber, with its partner, France-Philippines United Action Foundation, is carrying out here in the Philippines. And joining us still is Elodie Turpin, and she is the Executive Director of the FPUA. Joining her is Communications Corporate Communication Manager of Total Philippines, Anna Coscoluela. Welcome back, Elodie, and welcome, Anna, to Global Village.
Hi, good evening. Thank you, Buddy.
Now, it's so good that you're here because, you know, it's such a feel-good program we have today, talking about how we're all coming together with our French friends to really help not only promote trade and business here, but to help, of course, these communities in Cebu, and in Northern Cebu. Now, Elodie, we've been showing this video prior to us coming on, you know, on air. And it's a very powerful video that shows people in Northern Cebu that you guys have been helping. What can you tell us a bit about these, any interesting stories to share about this video?
Well, these communities actually are very touching. I get to visit them trying once a month. And even if we have some difficulty of communicating, obviously, because I do not speak Cebuano and they don't really speak Tagalog. So we still try to find the way to discuss. And I remember this mother with her two twins in her house, and she has a newborn, and this really live in difficult condition. Even if now we provide them homes, that's not enough. That's why we are still there. I mean, they don't even have proper equipment in their homes. For example, this mother, she doesn't have even a fan for her kids, and her kids were sick. But she was still very positive, very, very positive. That's what I love when I go there. You see the children, they are all running around, they come to us, they are always welcoming us very well. And they are very touching. All those kids, families, it feels so good, actually.
No, definitely. And then I think they're all very grateful that you guys are, you know, from France, and France-Philippines United Action Foundation is really, you know, pulling all the stops to help out in Northern Cebu. As I said, a lot of people concentrated in Leyte. Not many went to Northern Cebu, but I'm glad you guys are there. Now, Anna, welcome to Global Village.
And hi, buddy.
Let's talk about you and your French company, one of the biggest in the world and one of the biggest in the Philippines, Total Philippines.
Yes, so I work for Total Philippines. Total Philippines is the local affiliate for marketing and service of the Total Group. Total, of course, is the largest, one of the largest oil and gas companies in the world. And here in the Philippines, we are in the downstream petroleum market, which means we market finished petroleum products through our Total branded stations. And we also have our lubricants, special fluids, and other commercial fuels and products.
How long has Total been in the Philippines?
Actually, this year, we're celebrating our 20th year. So we were established in 1997 at the time of the oil deregulation. So we've been here for 20 years, and we are... And at this point where we are really growing in the market, we are opening stations throughout the country.
Yes.
And we are very aggressive, and we'd like to see more of our consumers being able to enjoy Total products.
Yes, I do notice that you guys are more visible in the countryside than here in Manila. I mean, you guys have more stations outside, no?
Yes, although the approach is to be able to reach the entire Philippines. So we're doing that across all fronts, and we're happy to be able to bring the Total brand to as many people as possible.
Let's talk about your corporate social responsibility projects. And one of those projects is this project in Northern Cebu. But tell us a bit about the overall vision of Total when it comes to corporate social responsibility.
Well, we have our pillars of CSR. One would be, of course, road safety. And that's something that globally Total supports the advocacy of road safety because we are in that space. There is child welfare, which in the Philippines is also very close to our hearts. And there is environmental protection. And where France Philippines United Action comes in is actually under disaster resilience and preparedness. So for Total, we really take a keen interest in supporting the France Philippines United Action Foundation.
Yes, because those four pillars cover the three pillars of their foundation, really.
Yes.
And so you guys are perfect match, almost.
It is a perfect match. And also, as one of the largest French companies in the world, and of course in the Philippines, Total would like to be a good example for our other corporate brothers and sisters to show that this is the type of project, this is the type of foundation that we can support, that is trustworthy, that is able to change a lot of lives just through the little support that we can provide. It's just our responsibility as a responsible corporate citizen.
How do you choose your CSR partners? I mean, okay, France, Philippines United Action Foundation is one of them, but you also have others, I understand.
Yes, we do have others. Of course, we look at the reputation of the partner, how experienced they are in the space that they operate in. Of course, being in touch with the grassroots level of wherever they operate, those are the things we look for.
Yes. Now, Elodie, tell us a bit about the participation of Total in your foundation, specifically this project.
Well, Total has been with the foundation since the beginning. They are one of our founding members and one of our main donors as well. The previous president of Total was part of the board of FPUA, and now we have the new one that is also part of the board. So Total is very supportive of all the projects of FPUA, especially the rehabilitation project, which consists of the construction of houses for the communities in Northern Cebu.
Yes, and you guys have sponsored directly the construction of so many houses in the community, no?
That's correct. So Total, through our mother company in France, we supported the construction a lot of the houses in Site 2, which is located in
Barangay Paipai,
Daan Bantayan. And our continuing, what I'd like to highlight is our continuing support for the foundation is actually to ensure the sustainability of these communities, not just in the community where we directly provided funding, but for the other communities being built by the foundation. Because, you know, it happens where a lot of these donors, they come in, then they donate for the one time.
It's a one-time deal.
Yeah. But when you go and visit on the ground, you see that they have day-to-day needs. And for the community to be sustainable, they need things like livelihood, healthcare, education. Although, as Total, we cannot do it. We cannot provide all of these alone. But I believe that through the support we provide and just being there, it encourages other companies to do the same because it really does take a village to be able to change and make a better life for these people.
That's nice. And you guys are building a village over there with Total's help. And you know, I did mention this earlier when Vanessa was here. I said that, you know, what's admirable about this project, and we're showing some stills now on the screen, of I think this is a groundbreaking ceremony that you guys had, and these are some of the recipients. And these are some of the actual houses that you guys have built in Northern Cebu. And the thing I like about this project is the comprehensive, that integrated approach, sustainable approach. Because as we know from the tragedy of what was post rehabilitation Leyte, a lot of money went in, they did some bunk houses, and that was it. But for you guys, you're doing something different. This is a very nice approach.
Yes, and I think how we do it differently, not just for Total, but our other members as well in the foundation. We do it very quietly. We really do it for the sake of doing good, for the sake of changing the lives of these people. We don't have much fanfare when we do. When we go, we just really want to sincerely check on the situation of the people on the ground.
Sure.
And that's worked well for us. Until recently, we haven't been attracting too much attention, but still we work with our partners, we work with the local government, we work with for the community to be able to do the things that need to be done to set up all the necessary support structures for the community.
Elodie, this community that you guys are doing in Northern Cebu, what phase are you in? Would you say you are in the mid phase or you're approaching, you know, final development? What is the status of this project? Because it started in 2013 and it's an ongoing project to make it a sustainable, comprehensive, integrated community.
Yeah, that's true. So the housing rehabilitation sites that we have in Daan Bantayan, we are currently implementing additional projects such as education sponsorship. And as well, we will soon be implementing a health mission by the end of the year. So
health mission, what do you mean by that?
We will have a dental mission.
Okay,
so
to go there and
we are
to
partnering
look after
with a French NGO for
okay.
that
okay.
and French dentist who will volunteer for about 5 days and we'll treat for free all the beneficiaries of our sites.
Very good.
So that's also a way to contribute for them to the community because those beneficiaries they don't really have the means to go and have access to proper healthcare.
Yes.
So we start by the dental mission and hopefully we can add other health mission in the future.
What about infrastructure-wise? Are you planning any infrastructure expansion in the community that you've built?
In the one that we built, as of now, we don't have any additional projects in terms of construction. We are building a third rehabilitation site in another municipality in Bogo, so still in northern Cebu, where we are building 46 disaster-resilient houses. The construction has been almost completed, but now we are on the phase of the site development because we cannot just provide homes, we also need to provide electricity, water, at least the connection to it, because then it will be up to the beneficiary to connect it or
yes.
not. But then we also build a multipurpose center because it's very important, a place where they can gather and also have their monthly meeting. It's also a place where we could potentially do seminars, CSR activities with them. And as well, in the first site that we have, the multipurpose center has been converted into a daycare center. So it's really up to the community to decide how they want to use it. So site development, it's a very important part of the project. We don't just do construction, give the roof, and it's okay. We really want to have a proper village, a place where they can really feel at home, and with a proper road, a proper garden. So we really help them until that. And then we will implement other projects.
Well, as your private sector partner said, it takes a village to change the world.
Yeah, and I think what's notable with how, what's very French about how we implement this project is there's always some innovation involved. For example, in the second site, there is a solar power system there. For our third site, we're also installing solar-powered streetlights. We're also exploring very innovative ways to construct the road. So it's not just about building
rehab.
A house and rehab, but really putting some thought into it. And just from the design of the house itself, that is super, super innovative. And that's why it appeals so much to the French community to do things really better, to build back better, and not just for the sake of building.
And they said, not just providing rehab, but actually providing a model that other communities can look at, like the solar power streetlights, and you know, maybe a different way to make the roads, right? And you know, to make it sustainable and eco-friendly and all that.
Yes, and we're open to sharing whatever lessons we learned, because I think, and a lot of other foundations who work post Haiyan experience the same, a lot of pains in how to get all these projects off the ground. So we and the foundation are very open to sharing our experiences with other foundations or other interested groups to see how we can implement these types of projects better, more efficiently, not just from a cost perspective, but also from resources and time, because we want to be able to shorten the time to be able to deliver these services to the beneficiaries.
Very good. And I think that's where the success of your foundation and relatively young foundation has the sources, really, getting all these dynamic people together with wonderful ideas and coming together for a good project, right? And having the vision and having the expertise. There you go.
We meet every month. They are all volunteered. I mean, so they bring their expertise, and that's how we are now. I mean, that's thanks to them that we are at this point right now. So hopefully we will grow and we'll have more projects, more members.
Anna, LED, we have to unfortunately come to the end of the show, but I'm going to leave it a few seconds to you to tell people how they get in touch with the France Philippines United Action Foundation, how they can help.
So if you're interested to contribute to France Philippine United Action Foundation, you can contact me through email at coordination@frenchunitedaction.ph. Visit also our website, frenchunitedaction.com. And there are many, many ways to contribute. It's not necessary always financial help. You can also have CSR activities. You can also do fundraising events for the foundation. So anything that you may have in mind, we are very much welcome to work with you and partner with you in the future. So
bravo, très bien. All right, so thank you very much, ladies, for coming to the show, and let me congratulate you and thank you again for the wonderful job you guys are doing. You guys are heroes.
Thank you very much.
So guys, I hope you enjoyed our show today on France Philippines Friendship. Join us again next week here in Global Village, and let us take you around the world. Till then, you all have a good evening.